I was raised on a farm in Wisconsin, a classical Wisconsin dairy and hog farm, and I was content to become a farmer, do what my father had done. I didn't even think about going to college.
Until he was in high school, and a vocational teacher encouraged him to apply for a scholarship at the University of Wisconsin to study animal science.
And I had, again, sort of a nonchalant attitude. Well, if I get it, I'll go, and if I don't get it, I won't go.
Well, he got it, and Schomburg's life was propelled on a very different course than that of a Wisconsin dairy and hog farmer. It eventually led to NIH-funded postdoctoral work in Cambridge, England, where his interest turned from farm animals to humans while working with celebrated reproductive biologist Roger Short. He would go on to become a groundbreaking researcher in the field of human reproductive biology. His team in Cambridge helped to discover an unknown activity produced in the uterus of pigs that was believed to have influence on the reproductive cycle.
But then the issue came up, was this also applicable to humans or to human medicine?
And that's what he came to Duke to flesh out in 1968 as an assistant professor of obstetrics and gynecology. He had high hopes for the new compound, hoping
that it would have opened up an entirely new field.
However, all tests in humans were negative for the new activity, but that's not a bad thing. Schomburg then changed course and focused on how growth factors influence reproductive hormone receptors. This research was his most important work at Duke and led to a seminal article published in the journal Science because his work has implications for improved management of fertility and for treating ovarian cancer.
It's very possible that markers for stem cells in combination with the receptors we are studying could come up to a methodology of combating cancer.
His pioneering work has been recognized with the Distinguished Service Award from the Society for the Study of Reproduction and with invited lectureships around the world. Schomburg and his wife Doris live on a 100-acre farm near Hillsboro. They stopped raising animals after their two sons left for college. The couple has five grandsons. To relax, there is one pursuit for Schomburg that rises above the rest.
Fly fishing for trout is my supreme outside interest. I just love it. Where trout are, it is almost by definition beautiful. Cold water, high elevations, wonderful view, so on and so on.
As for the view behind him as he transitions into retirement, Schomburg said he is grateful for the opportunities that Duke has given him.
I have very, very much enjoyed being a part of Duke University and Duke University Medical Center. It's a wonderful place.